School Blues Guitar. It is time for the song breakdown for the months of October through December 2018. And by request, we're going to take a look at Lowell Fulson's Reconsider Baby. It's in the key of G, and as is typical with Lowell Fulson, he plays the intro to the song and the two solos entirely within the boundaries of the first position blues box. The interesting thing is how many different licks he comes up with, a lot like B.B. King. You know, he's able to be extremely creative and never really sounds stale, never repeats the same thing in quite the same way. Now, instead of going through the entire introduction and both solos note for note, which would take a while, instead I'm just going to kind of skip through some of the more interesting licks and ideas, and then I've got it all tabbed out for you, and you can just print out the tabs, and if you want to figure this whole thing out note for note, you can do it. I've done it for you. But let's talk about the introduction. Let's start out with the introduction and go through that first. He starts out with these real cool slides, and he goes from the third to the fifth fret on the fourth string, then on the third string, and then back to the fourth string. Really neat stuff. And then he goes into the first of these single string runs. And this is where, you know, if you listen to a lot of Lowell Fulson stuff, this is how he played. And this little run here, the first lick that I have tabbed out for you in the introduction, he's just following the notes in the first position, G blues box, right over the G seventh chord. So we're starting from the sixth fret of the second string, 6-5-3, and then a little hop there, bending up on the fifth fret of the third string with my first finger on the third fret of the second string. This little lick, typical Lowell Fulson type thing. So the whole lick, then he's going to go 5-3 on the third string, wind up on the fifth fret of the fourth string, which is our G. And he's going to climb back up, and I'm going 3-4 on the third string, third fret of the second string, and then a choked off bend on the fifth fret of the second string. So that whole first lick, which is really neat. The second lick that he goes into is kind of cool. He's going to do something like this. And this idea where he ends up with this back and forth between the third fret of the second string and the fifth fret of the third string, this is something you'll hear several times in the intro and also in the solos of this song. He leads into it with, again, the sixth fret of the second string, but this time he bends it just a little bit and holds it. And then right to the fifth fret, to the third fret on the second string, and then the back and forth lick. Whoops. The hold. Something like that. So far in the introduction of the song, we've got and then he's going to go into this. This is another typical Lowell Fulson lick. Now we're moving over to the first string. Instead of just following all the way through, we're going. So 6-5-3 on the first string, bending up on the sixth fret of the second string with my first finger still at the third fret of the first string. So we've got. And then we're quickly going 6-5-3 on the second string. Like that. And we got another bend. So you see a lot of these ideas, these single string runs combined with these hops. this is what he's doing, and he's playing this all within the first position blues box in the key of G. So you can follow the introduction all the way through, and he just does a number of different things here that he's going to repeat throughout the song. A real neat thing he does is this climbing lick into the fifth fret of the second string. Something like that. Check out the tab. This is lick number 6 on the tab. Bending the fifth fret of the second string. That's another kind of a common Lowell Folsom lick. And then as he wraps up this whole thing, he does something like this. And so this lick, climbing from the third fret of the second string to the fifth fret, to the third fret of the first string, and then a quick double stop, which I'm going to choke off with my right hand palm. For this, I have my pinky on the sixth fret of the first string and my ring finger on the fifth fret of the second string. And we're just going to do the descending lick again. Like he winds up on the fifth fret of the fourth string. And then to wrap up the intro, and he uses this lick or something very close to it at the end of each verse of the solo, the two solo verses. He plays something like this. A little bass run. And he's going to start on the fifth fret of the fifth string, which is a D. Go to the third fret of the fourth string, and then a chromatic run, 5-4-3 on the fifth string. So we've got this. Then he wraps it up with a single string run. Something like that. And then into the five, the turnaround to wrap up the first solo, or the introduction to the song. So all these ideas, you're going to hear him doing this throughout the song. So the introduction is a good place to start and just get familiar with some of these. Now let's go into the solos, and again, I'm just going to highlight some of the licks, some of the things he does that are more, let's say, that I think you can take and apply to your own playing without necessarily trying to play what he played note for note. The first solo, he starts out with this real cool little lick. We've already done something similar to this. He goes like this. So I'm climbing this 3-5-3 climb on the second and the first string. You'll hear this 2 or 3 times throughout the solos in this song. And then the idea of choking up on that double stop. And then he does it again. And this little lick here, quick hammer-on pull-off between the third fret and the fifth fret of the first string. That's another common Lowell Folsom idea. So we go here and set up the next run with that hammer-on pull-off. Something like that. Another cool idea that you hear in the first solo, and this is phrase number 5 on the tab, is kind of this climbing arpeggio that he does over that first position G blues box. He does something like this. And I'm not sure that's not exactly what he plays, but starting on the fifth fret of the fifth string, he goes 3-5 on the fourth string, and then very quickly 3-4 on the third string, to the third fret of the second string. And a lot of times he'll go from the third fret of the first string and kind of hold the sixth fret of the second string. But it's that climbing. That's something that he does. He also does a lot of rakes in the song where he'll kind of quickly drag the pick down the strings. He does this in the first solo. There's one point where he wraps up a phrase something like this, where he just quickly gets what is basically the F-shaped position of the G chord, the third, second, and first strings. Something like that. He also does something like this on the second and third string, where he drags the pick down and gets the third and second string before going into a run. So those little rakes, those are part of the Lowell Folsom style as well. And a lot of times as he wraps up these licks, I'll just do these little, you know, sequences of notes on the second, or actually third and fifth frets between the third and fourth strings. It's really pretty simple. But, you know, the way he does it, he doesn't do it the same way twice. As I said, he mixes it up so it sounds fresh. Now the second solo is a lot more of the same, a lot of the same positions. One thing he does really cool is he wraps up the first part of the second solo is he does something like this, which is kind of a neat lick. It's a double stop on the sixth and fifth frets of the first and second string. Then he combines it with this lick where he just drags the pickup on the third fret of the first string, third fret of the second string. A lot of times you'll hear an electric blues something like this, single string. So what Lowell Folsom is doing there is just starting it with a double stop, which is a neat idea. And then he goes into this descending lick, which is a really neat lick. So this one is a couple double stops. Fifth fret, second or first and second strings to the third fret, and then into that single string run on the second string, 6-5-3, so like this. Really kind of cool. And then into one of these hops. That's a really neat Lowell Folsom idea that you hear in the second solo. He also does this little sequence where he just kind of fiddles around between the second and the second, third, and fourth string, something like this. Where he's just moving around on those three strings between the third and the fifth fret. I've got it tabbed out for you, at least as close as I can in the solo. That part is kind of hard to hear exactly what he's doing. But that's about it. If you go through Lowell Folsom's Reconsider Baby, again, every lick is within that first position blues box. Now, if you go through and figure out the whole solo and memorize it and can play it note for note, good for you. But I think the most valuable thing with learning these solos is just picking out some licks that you can use, even if you just pick out one. And for me, going through this solo, the one I really like is this one. Just combining the double stops with the single string runs and the hop there. So, Reconsider Baby by Lowell Folsom. I've got it all tabbed out for you. You can go through and figure out exactly what he's doing. It's all right there in the first position blues box. And the licks that I've showed you are just, you know, some of the highlights from the two solos and the introduction. Hope this lesson was helpful. And I will be back again in about 3 months with another breakdown of a traditional electric blues song. See you then.